This is a News Channel 2 special report.
We have some breaking news for you on Hillary Clinton's visit to Utica. We have some information now that she's granting us a live interview. Our own Bill Warden is there at the Eastside Senior Center with the very latest. We'll go there right now.
She indeed is. Hello, Susan, and welcome to a very special moment here with the First Lady of the United States. Hillary Rodham Clinton is with us. Welcome. We welcome you to Central New York. We're glad to have you.
Thank you. I'm delighted to be here.
And probably somewhat bushed after a couple of days now.
Well, I've had a great 2 days. Mm-hmm. And I've met a lot of wonderful people, as I did just now here at the Senior Center. So I feel very fortunate that I've gotten to hear so much and learn so much already.
One of the major things that are of interest to Central New York is especially the Utica-Rome area. We've lost an air base. Mm-hmm. So many communities have. It's meant a loss of 8,000 jobs in this community. If you're elected, what do you hope to do to turn that around?
Well, I think it's very important that all levels of government work together and work with the private sector to create the best possible conditions for good jobs and overall economic development. I would be very interested in making sure that the air base got all the attention it needed to continue to develop new economic opportunities there. I mean, it's a great resource if it is used right and if it's used to attract new jobs. I also am very much in favor of working hard to make sure that New York gets its fair share from Washington. You mm-hmm. know, we have learned that New York sends a lot more money to Washington than it gets back. But I also think that in addition to that, we have to look at the high electricity rates, we have to look at the high cost of transportation. There are a lot of factors that need to be worked on, but I'm confident that with people working together and not pulling apart, we could see some more jobs coming in.
New York State is also among the highest taxed states in the country. It also has some of the greatest public service programs, but those cost money. Where's the dividing line there? How can we get out from under that?
Well, that's why I raised the fair share issue, because, you know, last year New York sent $14.2 billion more to Washington than it got back. Well, there needs to be some balancing there. Other states are taking advantage of their position, and they send a lot more, they get a lot more in receipts from the federal government than they send in tax revenues. So I think that's one area that could really bear some looking into. And then I believe that at the local level, the tax burden in New York may have to be looked hard at to determine how to get it down so that businesses and individuals feel that they can really commit to the future.
Now, Mayor Giuliani recently was asked whether he would pledge to serve out his full term if he's elected to the Senate. He declined. What's your position on that?
Well, if I were to run and were so fortunate as to be honored with the people's trust here in New York, I am committed to serving a full term in the Senate.
Yeah, would it be too early to ask you if that's a stepping stone even in your mind to a higher office?
No, I'm just really looking one step at a time. I'm trying to make up my mind right now about a very big step for me that I've been encouraged to take by New Yorkers from all walks of life to run for this position. And I want to spend, you know, a lot of time thinking hard about that. And if I decide to run, I would be determined to do the best job I could and would look forward to representing the people of New York in the Senate.
Going to be at Woodstock?
I don't think so, not this year.
Well, that's it. Thank you so much,
you.
Hillary Rodham Clinton, our First Lady of the United States, paying a visit to Central New York today. And Susan, back to you.
All right, thanks, Bill. I want you guys to stay tuned because we'll be right back after this commercial break.